As I said, this guy says I can get it for £50 a year. I said, go to him. I nearly fell out with him, but I never. I said, okay, that's fine. He came back to me, yeah. He didn't do that particular course with me. But he came back to me. That was a £50 course, that was, yeah. This is what I'm talking about when I say synergistic relationships. He came back to me and spent £1,000 on a course after that time period.
On one course?
Yeah, it was a close protection course he did. And he came back to me. So I avoided. Now, the way I emailed him, I was a bit cheesed off because I knew the guy very well. And I was a bit cheesed off at the start. I said, if you can get it cheaper, there's no way I can cover that because that just covers my registration fee. My training fee doesn't cover. I said, I charge up to £150-£200 a day for training fee, that is freelancing. So I can't do it. But I said, if you want to do it, he knew I was cheesed off with him, and he goes, but they can do this. I said, go there then. I said, but just remember one thing. There's a difference between a BMW and a Skoda. I'm not knocking down Skoda or anything like that. But I said, there's a big difference. If you're going for quality, come and see me. Because that's where I feel on quality. And he goes, no problem, because I just left it there. But he came back to me about 4 months later and completed £1,000 course, which is a close protection. I don't run that anymore because I was working with another organisation to deliver that, working through and using them as their own body. And but you know what I didn't do? I didn't burn the bridge. I felt it was crucial to keep that line of communication open because you don't know what the customers are going to want from you afterwards. Over £50, I'm going to fall out of it. Came back. Or if it's, you relay the question to the group, you ricochet it, yeah, to the expert, reverse the question, I sometimes reverse it, yeah, or to the asker, yeah, what do you think? Somebody asks you a question, you're finding it, so what do you think though? What are your views on that? And you throw it back at them, and I say, well, I think this, okay, alright, those are your views, fair enough. I've had a group of people sit in front of me and say to me, there's no jobs out there. But I had three members of the group turn around and say, there are jobs out there, and I'm going to find them. That's why I'm here today. You know what I said to the group? I said, you are your reality and what you believe. So if you believe there's no jobs out there, you'll never find them. I say, you're right. I said, according to your experience, there's no jobs out there. But according to yours, who you believe, you'll find a job.
Yeah, there's jobs out there.
Yeah. You'll find something because you're on a search and you're determined. And it just seems to me that you've hit a bad season. So in terms of what you're saying here, I mean, that's one way that I've, that's a good example of it. Someone said, well, you are, and the thing is, I wasn't going to get into a dispute over whether there are jobs out there. I know there's jobs out there. But I said, you need to listen to the presentation, because at the end of the presentation, I've got some key pointers for you to help you with the job search. However, if you want to stick to the belief, that's up to you. It's your choice.